everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all doing well. For today's video, I have got another subscribers draw my nail art video. Today's design was picked out by Gina from Nails with Gigi. She has picked me out a gorgeous Mickey Minnie Mouse sort of design, something completely different to my normal sort of sets, a bit of freehand involved, and yeah, I'm really excited about this set. It's a super cute set, super girly, super sweet, and I absolutely love it. If you're not already following Gina, you can find her on YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram. I will link all of her stuff down in the description box if you'd like to check out her social media accounts. She's an absolute angel. She's really sweet, fantastic at nail art, and you guys absolutely love her, so please go subscribe to her if you haven't already. But otherwise, I hope you all enjoy it. I'm going to crack straight on, and I'll talk to you guys through the process. But yeah, other than that, let's get started. Okay, so I started off by going in with 011 from Emily, which is a white gel polish. I've just done 3 nails of that, and then I'm going in with the Beatles matte top coat, my favourite matte top coat. I always love this top coat. And yeah, I'm literally just mattifying all the nails so I can freehand paint on them. I always say this, but I always matte top coat my nails if I'm going to be freehanding, just simply because it makes it easier. I feel like the paint goes on better, and also the light doesn't reflect in them, which is very helpful. And then for this nail, right, I do end up redoing this nail towards the end of the video because I decided it just wasn't the right match. I went in with 3 different glitters and I tried to recreate the glitter mix that was on the picture that Gina sent me, but I just didn't have the right sort of glitter mix. I tried to make one and I decided I didn't like it, and I go in with a different glitter at the end. I'm going in with a base coat, just putting a good layer of that on the nail, and then I'm using that to sort of stick the glitter to the nail before I encapsulate it. I'm going to be encapsulating it with some Builder in a Bottle from Emily. I really like the Builder in a Bottle, like the product itself is really nice, but I've kind of come to the conclusion that I actually prefer Builder gel inside of a tub and just getting it out myself with a normal gel brush. I'm not too keen on these Builder in a Bottles. I just find it a little bit awkward to get product out. So I'll definitely be opting just for a normal tub of Builder Gel in the future. But otherwise, it's a really nice product. It works well. It's really nice and clear. And I really can't fault it. It's really affordable and a good consistency and nice and easy to work with. But yeah, I'm just encapsulating the glitter with that. I do prefer acrylic for encapsulating, but until I can afford to go get a bottle of Odorless Monomer, you're probably not going to see acrylic on my channel for a while. I do really like doing acrylic. I can do acrylic nails to some extent. I'm not the best at it, but I can do it. It's just the smell of Monomer just really isn't great. I think all our girls know that problem, so I've just sort of been opting for gel instead. But yeah, I just filed and buffed that down and then added a nice glossy top coat to it. Then I'm moving on to the baby finger, where I am freehand painting the word love, just like in the picture. I'm using my Ikikai brush that I got off AliExpress. It's a really good brush, my favourite brush, and it's super affordable as well. It's like £1.47 or something like that off AliExpress. Super cheap, but it's so thin and makes life so much easier when it comes to freehand. I did struggle painting this word. I love freehand painting, but I don't love freehand painting words. I really struggle. It's okay if they're sort of just like a basic font, but when you're trying to do like all swirly like patterns and make it look all pretty, it can be quite difficult. And instead of doing the zero on the word love, I'm putting in the Mickey Mouse head instead. Well, it's actually Minnie Mouse. I'm going to add a bow in a moment. But in all honesty, it did take me a little while to do this word. I did keep wiping it off and sort of redoing it. It's just kind of hard to get proportions completely right and just make it work. It can just be really difficult sometimes. But I'm pretty happy with how it came out. I'm just using the Black Emily gel polish there as well. It's really pigmented, really nice gel polish. I want to get myself some of those painting gels that you get in the little pots, but I just haven't got around to buying any yet. But yeah, I'm just going in here, I'm painting a little white bow. I'm using white just to make the red more pigmented, because if I put a red on top of black, it won't really show up. So I'm just sort of using the white to make the pigment of the red come through more, so it's nice and bright and vibrant. But again, just going in with 064 from Emily, nice bright red gel polish. I really like how Emily gel polish is good quality gel polish. I love the consistency. Most of it is pretty damn pigmented, and yeah, overall I really like it and definitely would recommend it. And then I'll just matte top coat it again, seal it all in, and that is that nail complete. Then I'm moving on to the middle finger, where I'm using 329 pink gel polish from Beatles. This was in the Perfect 20 collection. it's not the most pigmented of gel polish. It's kind of like, if you paint a full nail with it, it's more sort of got that jelly effect to it. But I thought that was perfect for this particular set because I didn't want the pink to be too bright and vibrant. I kind of like that sort of sheerness to it, just because this is more of like the background art of this nail, and I'm going to be painting Mickey and Minnie onto this nail in the moment. So I'm just literally going around painting hearts all at different angles, just like the picture. I really did try my best to recreate this set exactly how it was in the picture. I think this colour matched absolutely perfectly with what was in the picture as well. But yeah, once I've done that, I sort of wipe down with IPA. I always wipe down with IPA once I've cured the design, just to sort of make sure that when I use top coat, the pigment from the gel polish doesn't run, because sometimes it does do that with gel polish. So then I wiped it down, I matte top coated it, and then I'm going in, I'm painting a white heart again, just like before. It sort of covers up part of the other hearts that I've done, and also makes it so when I add the red on top, it's truly pigmented, bright and vibrant, like how it should be. I was really happy with how this nail turned out. Actually, I thought it was going to be a lot harder than it did, but first time round I managed to paint it, and I was happy. There weren't really any mistakes. It's not perfect. None of my freehand is perfect. I'm slowly getting better, I like to think, but it can be quite difficult. But yeah, no, I was pretty happy with how this turned out. As you can see, I'm literally just outlining the heart of black as thin as I possibly can. That's what I love about this brush. It enables you to be able to paint really thin lines when you want to. It's fantastic. I've bought brushes that are like over a tenner, very well-known popular brushes, and yet I think this little cheap one from AliExpress is so much better, and this will forever be my favorite freehand brush. I don't think anything's going to compare to it. For the price and the quality, you really cannot go wrong. So if you're looking for a good freehand brush, trust me, you'll love this one. Yeah, I'm just painting Mickey here, and then I'll be going in and painting Minnie. As you saw there with Minnie, I sort of painted like part of her top, and then I went onto the bottom of her, just sort of helped get those proportions right. And then just painted the center, wiped it down IPA again, and matte top coated it. And then I'm going on to the index finger, where in the pictures Gina sent me, she had one picture with a Mickey Mouse charm and then one picture with a little metal rhinestone bow. I don't really have anything that sort of matches with those or that I liked enough, so I decided just to use one black rhinestone, well, one big black rhinestone and then two smaller black rhinestones to sort of create a Mickey Mouse head. And that was that nail done. And then lastly, as you can see, yeah, I swapped out this nail and decided to go in with the Ooh La La glitter mix from Sparkle Supplies. I think it just matched a lot better with the set and just looked a whole load better. I thought it was a really good choice for this particular set. It's the closest I could get to what Gina had in her picture, and I just felt like it just went better with this set than what the first nail did. It's a really gorgeous glitter mix, and I actually decided to leave this nail matte. I don't normally, if I'm using glitter, I don't normally leave a matte. I generally always put a glossy top coat on it, but I actually went with matte this time and I was really happy with it. But just like before, I'm literally just encapsulating it with builder gel. I'll file and buff it down and then whack on the top coat. And then I decided to go in with some black rhinestones again, just a couple of tiny little ones, just in a line, just to kind of bring it all together a bit more. I just felt like it needed a bit of black on it, this nail. I know Gina's picture didn't have that, but I felt like it just brought it all together a bit more. And yeah, overall I was pretty happy with how this set turned out. Gina, I really hope you like it. I really did try. It was a fun set to do, something a bit different for me. And yeah, overall I quite like it. I'm quite happy with it. So I hope you guys have all enjoyed as well. It's been a right nightmare getting this video up. Yeah, I hope you've all enjoyed it. If you have, please remember to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And other than that, much love, and I shall see you in the next video. Bye. Thank you.